Welcome back to our science session. So let us start our science session with the first chapter, nutrition in plants. So I hope children you have some idea about the nutrition in plants. So as you know, food is very essential for all the living organisms. Why? Because we get energy from the food. So there are different components of food. Already answered it in the last class, that is in 6th standard, you have learnt about the food and the components of the food. So what are the components of the food? Those are carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals and fats. So these are the components of the food. Okay, carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals and fats. So these components of the food we call them as nutrients. Okay, so nutrients are these different components of the food. So you know the sources of this food. So carbohydrate sources, rice, potato. Okay, so proteins, that is egg and meat. Okay, vitamins is fruits and vegetables. So minerals you get it from different sources, and fats such as oil and ghee. So all these comes from different sources. So in detail you answered in the last class, that is in 6th standard. So that means these components of food we call it as nutrients. So all this food comes from, all living organisms require food. So food is prepared by plants. You know that plants are the only organisms that can prepare its own food. So how about animals and human beings? Can we prepare our own food? No. So we are depending upon the plants and the animals that feed on the plants. So food cannot be prepared by animals or human beings. It can be only prepared by the plants. So let us discuss in this chapter how the food is prepared and how it is essential for all the living organisms. So let us know about the nutrition in the plants. Before that, let us study the mode of nutrition. Plants or animals that they are feeding. Okay, so there are two modes of nutrition. So before that, going to the mode of nutrition, let us know what is the nutrition. Okay, so as you know, the plants are the only organisms that can prepare the food. How they are preparing the food? By making use of the raw materials. What are the raw materials required for the plants to grow? That is carbon dioxide, water and minerals. Okay, so these are the raw materials that are necessary for the plants to grow. So how they are getting the raw materials? These are present in the surroundings, isn't it? Carbon dioxide is, they are getting it from the air. Water, that is from the rain and different sources. Minerals from the soil. So these raw materials are present in the surroundings so that the plants can grow. So using these raw materials, the plants can prepare its own food. And as you know, the nutrients are very essential for the body, so that it helps in repairing the damaged parts of the body and helps in building the body, and it is also necessary for different mechanisms that can be easily operated in our body. So there are different mechanisms like digestion, respiration, circulation. So to undergo all this process, you require energy. So where does it come from? From the food. So food is very essential for all the living organisms. So now we should study about what is the nutrition. So nutrition is the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization. Okay, nutrition is the mode of taking food. Okay, so there are different modes of taking food. I have already told you, so that we'll discuss. So the mode of taking food, that is, it may be autotroph or heterotroph. So these are the two modes. So the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization. So how this food is utilized in the body. So that we call it as a nutrition. So we, I have already told you about the definition of the nutrition. So let us study about the mode of nutrition. So first one is autotrophic nutrition. So autotrophic nutrition is the mode of nutrition. Is the mode of nutrition in which organisms produce or prepare the food by making use of simple substance. For example, plants. Okay, so plants are called as autotrophs, isn't it? We call plants as autotrophs. Why? They are preparing their own food by making use of simple substance. So here auto is self, trophy means nourishment. So we call it as autotrophs. So it is a mode of nutrition in which the organisms can prepare its own food by making use of simple substance. Simple substance is nothing but the raw materials, the whatever I have told now, carbon dioxide, water and minerals. So making use of these simple substances, they are preparing their own food. Best example is the plants. So we call the plants as the autotrophs. So in heterotrophic nutrition, the organisms cannot prepare their own food. So they depend upon the plants or the animals that feed on the plants. So here hetero means other, trophic means nourishment. So heterotrophic nutrition means it is the mode of nutrition in which the organism depend upon others for their food. So we call them as a heterotrophic nutrition. So the examples are like human beings and animals. So these are the two modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. So there must be some confusion that is going on in you. So like where are these raw materials present? I told you already that raw materials are present in the surroundings. So where, what is the factory, food factory of the plants, where it is situated, and how these raw materials are transported to that food factory, and how the raw materials that are transported, that is used in the preparation of the food. So all this confusion we will discuss in the next session, and we will get the answers for all these questions. So till then, thank you.